सिरोसिस ऑफ लीवर, इट इज़ द एंड स्टेज ऑफ एनी क्रोनिक किडनी डिजीज एंड हैज़ थ्री पार्ट्स इन इट्स डिफिनेशन. मीन्स द फर्स्ट विल बी द एंड स्टेज ऑफ एनी क्रोनिक किडनी डिजीज कैरेक्टराइज बाई थ्री कंपोनेंट, दैट इज ब्रीजिंग सेप्टा ऑफ फाइब्रोसिस, द अदर इज द deterioration of the normal architecture and structure, disruption of architecture and structural abnormality. The third component is formation of nodule that may be either micro or macro nodule, or it may be of mixed type. The third component is the nodule, and there are usually three types of nodule. It may be micro nodule, macro nodule, or of mixed variety. So these were the three component in the definition of cirrhosis of liver. It is end stage of any chronic liver disease which is characterized by bridging septa of fibrosis with the disruption of the architecture and structural abnormality, and with the formation of, which results in the formation of nodule, which may be micro, macro or mixed type of nodule. Now we will look for the cause behind the cirrhosis of liver. The cause can be remembered as बाबा, एमडी बाबा. एमडी बाबा इज द कॉज. ओके, सो बी इज फॉर द बिलियरी, एंड देयर मे बी टू पैथोलॉजी इन द बिलियरी सिस्टम. देयर मे बी बिलियरी सिरोसिस एंड देयर कैन बी बिलियरी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, एंड द बिलियरी ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन कैन बी via gallstone formation. Usually the biliary cirrhosis is of four types. It may be primary biliary cirrhosis, secondary biliary cirrhosis, primary sclerosing type of biliary cirrhosis, sclerosing type of biliary cirrhosis, or it can be autoimmune type, autoimmune. The other biliary disorder was due to biliary obstruction. Biliary obstruction is due to gallstone formation. Biliary obstruction. A is for the autoimmune or alcohol. First of all, we need to know that alcohol is the greatest cause behind the cirrhosis of the liver, that constitute about 60%, 60 to 70% of the cause. 60 to 70% of the cause is due to alcohol, and V is for the virus induced, that is viral hepatitis. A can be autoimmune. M is for the metabolic disease. There are a lot of metabolic disease that can cause cirrhosis of liver, that is like Wilson disease. Wilson, it can be Wilson disease, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency. It can be due to hemochromatosis or cystic fibrosis. And glycogen storage disease is also associated with cirrhosis of liver. Now D is for the drug. As we know that the nephrotoxic drug is remembered as mnemonics with the mate pink. So drugs like mate pink, PINK. Mate is for the methotrexate and P is paracetamol, isoniazid, nitrofurantoin and ketorolac. So these are the drugs associated with cirrhosis of liver. Now, a very important portion in the cirrhosis of liver is the pathogenesis. Suppose that these were the cause which were causing infection and inflammation in the liver. Then due to this cause, there is activation of the Kupffer cell, which are the macrocytes, macrophagic type of cell in the hepatocyte. So these all causes activation of the Kupffer cell in Kupffer cell, and this Kupffer cell cause activation of myelofibroblast like cells. Myelofibroblast like cell, and this cell activation causes intense amount of fibrosis. Means first of all, this myelofibroblast cell promotes chronic inflammation, which will result in widespread necrosis of the liver cell. Chronic inflammation से necrosis होगा, और necrosis के बाद में it will result in extensive fibrosis of the, and this fibrosis is the main pathology. Look, this this fibrosis causes the disruption in the normal architecture of the liver, and as a result, when the fibrosis decreases the amount of the normal cells, then the remaining amount of the small amount of the liver cell undergoes hyperplasia, which will result in the nodule formation. Okay, first of all, what happened? And due to the chronic inflammation, there was necrosis, and due to after necrosis, fibrosis started in those person. As a result, the normal of the amount of the cell decreased in the hepatocytes, means liver mein kam ho gaye cell. To jo bache hue cell rehte hain, the remaining cells undergoes hyperplasia, which result in the formation of nodule, and this nodule may be of three variant, that can be micronodule, macronodule, or mixed variant. So now we have reached the formation of the nodule, and but the fibrosis is not yet stopped, and this fibrosis will result even in the disruption in the vasculature. So when the vasculature are affected, that will result in the distortion of the pulmonary portal vein, and result in the abnormal drainage, which will result ultimately into the portal hypertension. Means fibrosis se do kaam hue, ek to bache hue cell undergoes hyperplasia resulting in nodule formation, and the next one is the distortion in the vasculature of the hepatocytes, which will result in portal hypertension. So this was the pathogenesis, and this portal hypertension later on undergoes ascites and hepatoencephalopathy, which may develop due to hepatocellular insufficiency. Okay, these were the result or pathophysiology behind the cirrhosis of a liver. Now, the clinical feature. The clinical feature has a very highly variable type of presentation. Usual presentation is usually they are asymptomatic type and diagnosed incidentally during ultrasonography for any other cause. Some of the non-specific type of symptoms can be weakness, fatigue, muscle cramp, weight loss, anorexia, nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. Okay, and the other related complication or other related disease like symptoms can be present in the cirrhosis. Suppose that there is hepatic insufficiency, then the symptoms will be accordingly. The symptoms may be of hepatic insufficiency. The symptoms may be of portal hypertension, like variceal bleed, hemorrhoid, or ascites like feature, and there can be hemorrhagic tendency. Now we will look for the stigmata or the chronic kidney disease feature. What are the signs related to chronic kidney disease? This is very important question. So the first sign will be liver size. Usually the liver size is enlarged in early stage, whereas if the case is of cirrhosis, due to the fibrosis, the liver size undergoes shrinkage. Okay, then we will look for the jaundice. There will be mild jaundice present. Jaundice will be mild in amount. Then the other specific feature will be spider navy, and the spider navy has a very characteristic blanching criteria, which is consist of central arteriole in the midline, and there are radiating type of branches from this central artery, and which is similar to the legs of the spider. As a result, it is called as spider navy type of telangiectasia. It is actually telangiectasia. Usually the normal site for the spider navy is on the chest, head, neck and limbs, and it can even be present on the back also. Then the other feature can be of ascites. They can also present with ascites and palmar erythema. It is usually due to increased peripheral blood flow. There may be endocrine change in both male and female, which will result gynecomastia, testicular atrophy and impotence in male, and amenorrhea in case of female, or irregular menses in female. There may be hemorrhagic tendency, and some of the feature of portal hypertension like splenomegaly, portosystemic collateral vessel, esophageal varices, and the tremor is specific in these cases, that is flapping or asterixis type of tremor, flapping tremor. Some of the other feature are like hyperpigmentation and very white type of nail can be there, called as tarry nail. There may be clubbing and cyanosis. Dupuytren contracture and parotid enlargement is also seen sometime. Parotid enlargement and dupuytren contracture, in which the palm, the skin of the palm is thickened. Dupuytren's contracture. Now we will look for the complication. As we knew that the cirrhosis had undergone portal hypertension, so it can be portal hypertension. The other complication can be hepatic encephalopathy. It can cause ascites, portal gastropathy can be there, hepatorenal syndrome can be seen, hepatocellular carcinoma, bleeding manifestation and coagulopathy. There may be cirrhotic cardiomyopathy or hepatic hydrothorax or cirrhotic osteodystrophy. So these were the common complications associated with cirrhosis. For the prognosis of the cirrhosis, usually Child's Pugh classification is done, and we will look for only the component of the Child's Pugh classification. The Child's Pugh classification has the component can be remembered as A, B, C, D and E. A is for the albumin level. We will look the albumin, then bilirubin, serum bilirubin, and C is the clotting factor. C is for clotting factor, and for the clotting factor we will look for prothrombin time, and D is the distension of the abdomen, that is ascites, and E is the encephalopathy grading. So this is the child poo classification, and it is scored as 1, 2, and 3 grading, and the interpretation is done according to the grouping of the patient. If the score is from 5 to 6, then they are grouped in group A, and 7 to 9 group B, and more than 9 they are of group C, or for the worst prognosis group. So the component were albumin, serum albumin, bilirubin, clotting factor ke liye prothrombin time, distension ke liye ascites dekhte hain, aur encephalopathy grading is done. Now the last component in the cirrhosis of liver will be our investigation and treatment component. For the investigation, we will look for the liver function test, hematological test for looking the peripheral blood smear, blood ammonia and electrolyte level will be examined, and at last we will send for imaging of the abdomen to find the other findings. So starting from the liver function test, under liver function test we will look for the bilirubin, protein, ALT AST ratio, ALP and prothrombin time. LFT mein kya aata hai, we will look bilirubin, then we will look the serum protein, which is usually decreased, and the bilirubin level in the serum as well as urine is usually raised, and the bilirubin, both the conjugated and unconjugated, are raised, okay, whereas the serum protein level is decreased. And ALT and AST, AST is to ALT ratio dekhte hain, and if it is more than 2, then it usually suggest for alcoholic cirrhosis, whereas if the AST to ALT ratio is less than 2, then it usually indicates for the viral cause of cirrhosis, okay. We will also look for the ALP, which is slightly raised, because it is very markedly raised in case of obstructive type of jaundice, slightly raised. We will also look for the prothrombin time, which is usually elevated, okay. Some of the hematological test mein peripheral blood smear will be sent, peripheral blood smear, in which we will look for anemia and acanthocytosis, leukopenia and thrombocytopenia can also be present, WBC and lymphocytes are also decreased, and some of the serological tests should be sent for the virus screening, and the other electrolyte imbalance should be diagnosed for sodium level usually, which is decreased, and potassium is also decreased. Magnesium and phosphate are also decreased. So this screening should be done, and at last imaging will be done, and for the imaging we can send USG ultrasonography, which will show the change in the shape and size of the liver, fatty change is present or not in the liver, cirrhosis means fibrosis, what is the significance, what is the significance of the cirrhosis, fibrosis in the cirrhosis disease, nodularity of the liver can also be seen in the USG, and enlargement of the spleen and ascites is also diagnosed with the help of USG. So it is a very relevant test usually sent during cirrhosis of the liver. Then the other imaging modality can be CT and MRI, endoscopy can also be done for detecting other varices and portal hypertensive gastropathy, endoscopy, and liver biopsy should be sent to confirm the diagnosis of the cirrhosis. Liver biopsy is the confirmatory test. biopsy confirms your diagnosis. Then there is for the treatment, you should know that there is no specific treatment for the cirrhosis of the liver, so you just have to stop or halt the progression of the cirrhosis. No specific treatment, so you just need to halt the progression. That can be done. The progression can be stopped by dietary modification, by giving high protein diet. We can the diet can be given with branched chain amino acid in the patient disposed to the hepatic encephalopathy. You should supplement vitamins and avoid the hepatotoxic drug like aspirin and NSAID. NSAIDs and aspirin, and reduce salt intake. So these were the non-specific and dietary modification. And some of the management, if the cirrhosis have undergone some of the complication like variceal bleeding in case of portal hypertension, hepatic encephalopathy and ascites, accordingly we need to support or treat these cases. So the follow-up should be usually every 6 months for the ultrasound and serum alpha fetoprotein. So this is about the cirrhosis of the liver, which has no specific therapy, but we can just halt the progression of this disease. Thank you.